गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, एज यस्टरडे वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द इलेक्ट्रोकेमिकल प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ मेटलर्जी और द इलेक्ट्रोमेटलर्जी, इन विच वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दैट पायरोमेटलर्जी इज नॉट एप्लीकेबल इन केस ऑफ वेरी लेस रिएक्टिव मेटल्स सच एज सोडियम, मैग्नीशियम, एल्यूमिनियम एटसेट्रा. सो वी हैव टू ऑब्टेन द मेटल बाय द इलेक्ट्रोलिसिस प्रोसेस. सो द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोलिसिस, in the application of electrolysis, first let's discuss the extraction of copper from low grade ore and scrap. So what are the low grade ore of copper? The low grade ore contains very less amount of copper and it cannot be obtained by pyrometallurgy. So for the process we are to leach the ore by a suitable acid or the bacteria by which copper metal goes in the solution. From the ore it must be gone to the solution, means it must be oxidized, which on treated either with Fe zinc or hydrogen, means to the more reactive metal or hydrogen gas, it can be reduced to the metallic form, means we can get the pure metal. During the process, as these are more reactive metals and hydrogen is also having the difference of E naught values in positive, so we are getting the del G naught value as negative. As we have discussed yesterday, according to the equation, del G naught is equal to minus NF E naught. So if we would be getting the value of del G naught as negative, the reaction would be feasible. So I have written as E naught of equation 1 is 0.78 volt, that is in positive, and for second is 0.34 volt. For this I have explained you yesterday also. So we are getting the del G naught as negative and the reduction of copper ion can occur in the solution. But as zinc is more expensive than iron, so we prefer to use iron scrap in comparison to zinc scrap. So now what is hydrometallurgy? The process is known as hydrometallurgy. The process of extraction of metal by dissolving the ore in a suitable reagent, as we have dissolved in a suitable acid or a bacteria, followed by precipitation or displacement. In the case we have seen the displacement, but precipitation can also be noticed when we have discussed about the leaching process, in which we have discussed about the silver and gold also. In the case the precipitation is taking place, so precipitation or displacement of the metal by a more reactive metal, in that case also we have used zinc, is known as hydrometallurgy. So we can say that leaching process, the Goldsmith process for silver and gold, and this process of displacement, as we have noticed now, is the displacement process in which we are to react first the ore with the suitable reagent. Thereafter, it is to be reacted to a more reactive metal by which the metal can be obtained. The process is known as the hydrometallurgy. Now, let's see the second application of the electrolysis process by the extraction of aluminium. Let's see the extraction of aluminium from bauxite ore. That is the most common ore by which we opt or extract aluminium. The formula is Al2O3. The first process that we have to go through is the leaching process, by which the number of impurities as iron, titanium oxide, iron oxide and silicon dioxide can be removed, and we would be able to get pure aluminium by Baird's process that we have already discussed in the concentration methods. Now the second step of the extraction of aluminium is the electrolytic reduction of pure alumina. We are getting the pure alumina by the Baird's process. So by going through the Hall-Herold process, as per its scientist name, we can opt the aluminium metal. But now there are two difficulties that we are to face during the electrolysis process of pure alumina. The first thing is the melting point of pure alumina is very high, that is around 2323 Kelvin, while the boiling point of aluminium is less than that, is around 2070 Kelvin. So if we do the electrolysis process at this temperature, so before the temperature the aluminium would be vaporized and we would not be able to collect it and got or extract the aluminium metal. The next thing is, it is a bad conductor of electricity in the fused state. So, to remove these difficulties, we are to add cryolite and fluorspar, that is Na3AlF6 and CaF2 to the alumina in 20:60:20, by which these two difficulties would be removed. The first thing is, the fusion temperature of this mixture is around 1170 Kelvin and it is a good conductor of electricity. For doing this process, we are to take this apparatus. It is having an iron tank that is having the carbon lining, work like cathode. The next is, the graphite rods suspended into the electrolyte work like anode, and a glowing lamp is attached to it. Now we are to take the fusion mixture, that is of alumina, Na3AlF6 and CaF2, and we are to take the layer of powdered coke on the surface of this electrolyte. Now let's see, on passing current, there must be these changes that will occur. That the cryolite, on passing electricity, the cryolite would be dissociated into sodium fluoride and aluminium fluoride, in which aluminium fluoride would be ionized to give aluminium ion and fluoride ion. Aluminium ion at cathode would be reduced to give molten aluminium, that is being heavier than that of the electrolytes, would be settled at the bottom. That we can see in the diagram also, that we have collected the molten aluminium, that is 99.5% pure, after the process is collected at the bottom. Now at anode, the fluoride ion would be oxidized into fluorine, that we can see here, and this fluorine formed convert the rest of the alumina to aluminium fluoride. That we are able to see is a good conductor of electricity. So we are again getting the aluminium fluoride from the alumina. So now this would not be again needed for the process. So alumina would be converted to aluminium fluoride, that can again dissociate it into aluminium ion and fluorine ion, fluoride ion, and the process would be go on. Now during this reaction, oxygen is also formed that attack on the anode rods, the graphite rods, and converts carbon to carbon monoxide and carbon to carbon dioxide. Means oxygen formed attack graphite rods to form carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide, and in this process, as we are getting the 1 kg of aluminium, the 0.5 kg of anode is burnt away. During the electrolysis, when we are producing 1 kg of aluminium, 0.5 kg of anode, means carbon rod, graphite rod that we have taken as anode, would be burnt away. So the graphite rods have to be changed, replaced time to time. That is a drawback of the process. So why we have taken the carbon coke powder on the surface of the electrolyte? First, let's see that. There are two reasons behind it. A layer of powdered coke we have taken just to slow down the consumption of carbon anode. Because the oxygen gas formed attack on carbon rod. So if we are taking the powdered coke on the surface of the electrolytic mixture, so the oxygen first reacts to the powdered coke and converts into the carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide. Thereafter, it would be able to attack. So we are not supposed to replace the anode very early. The next thing is, it check heat loss due to radiation, because we are to maintain the temperature as 1173 Kelvin. So these two things are there for taking the powdered coke as a uppermost layer. Now let's see, by the electrolysis process, the overall reaction what is taking place is, the aluminium reacts with coke to give aluminium and carbon dioxide. So for the by the process, we would be able to get 99.5% pure alumina. Now let's see, we have taken a glow lamp also in the process. So what is the use of taking glowing lamp here? That is joined parallel in the cell circuit. Now let's see, when the concentration of alumina is decreased, what will happen? The resistance of the cell increases and the glow lamp will glow as the extra current flows through it, and we would be able to know that there is the less concentration of alumina and we can add the alumina to the process. As now we are getting only 99.5% pure alumina, so refining of aluminium can also be done by the Hoops process. So refining of aluminium again by electrolysis by Hoops process can be done, by which we would be able to get 99.98% pure aluminium. So for the process also, we are to take an iron tank having carbon lining which work like an anode, and we are to take again the carbon rods that work like a cathode. Now in the tank we are to take three layers that are having different specific gravities, or you may say the different densities. The lowermost layer would be of impure aluminium that can be added by this hopper. The middle layer is of the electrolyte that contains the fluoride of sodium, aluminium and barium, as we are able to see NaF, AlF3 and BaF2, and the uppermost layer would be of pure aluminium. So when the electricity is passed, what will happen? Aluminium from the middle layer moves towards the cathode and get aluminium ion would move towards the cathode and get reduced to get the pure aluminium, and the equivalent amount of aluminium would be moved towards the middle layer from the impure aluminium. So like this, the impure aluminium ion moves towards the middle layer, and from the middle layer of electrolyte it moves towards the uppermost layer that is of pure aluminium, and that can be taken out time to time by this tripping hole, and the impurities would be left behind finally at the bottom, and we would be able to get around 99.98% of pure aluminium by the Hoops process. Now you all are to make notes of the extraction of aluminium, and the question related to the low grade ore of copper is being asked in the examinations also. So write a short note on that also, that how it is to be done and what is hydrometallurgy, pyrometallurgy and electrometallurgy. This definition is also being asked in the examination, so focus on that also and try to solve the related NCERT as well as reference book question. Thank you.